Industrial Services Group, or ISG, is the end product of 95 years proud service to the disabled community in Bradford District. Situated in the heart of Bradford, the origins of ISG can be traced back as far as 1920, when the original foundation stone was laid at the paddock site. The building was originally commissioned by the Royal National Institute for the Blind to provide meaningful work for injured soldiers returning from the First World War. ISG has since gone through a number of changes of products and services and now consists of two Bradford factories, one manufacturing PVCU windows and composite doors, and the other manufacturing outdoor festival lights. We're a supported business, which is a term used by the Department for Work and Pensions in relation to factory environments that qualify to be part of the Work Choice Disability Employment Programme. Their main characteristic is that over 50% of the workforce has a disability. The primary aim of the Work Choice Programme is to facilitate provision of training to long-term unemployed disabled people, with the specific aim of getting them into work that is ideally sustained for at least 26 weeks after they complete the programme.
Industrial Services Group exists predominantly and almost exclusively because of what we do with people. The council as a whole does not need to have a factory within its operation that makes windows and doors, or for that matter makes festival lights. It's all about what we do for people. Our mission statement is about providing training and employment, and meaningful training and employment for people with disabilities in the Bradford District, and our aim is to give them the best chance they can to maximise their opportunity of actually getting meaningful work in the open field of work.
There are over 75 supported businesses across the UK, incorporating almost 5,000 training places for disabled people, achieving a combined commercial turnover of over £100 million per year, and employing in excess of 3,000 people. They are all managed on the principles of independent social enterprises, aiming to deliver their services to disabled people within commercially self-sustaining operations.
What we do first of all is they come and have a look around and see if it's something that will interest them. When they've had a look around, they will have a work trial. That can be up to 3 weeks long. And the idea is we're seeing what their capability is, but also seeing whether they really feel like they want to work with us for a period of time as well.
Supported businesses have solid reputations with their customers for providing high quality products and services at competitive prices, what we know as best value. The vast majority of our customers trade with us on a fully commercial basis, unaware, in many instances, that we are actually a social enterprise. By working with social enterprises such as ISG, customers can also support corporate social responsibility objectives.
One of the added benefits that our customers and potential customers can get from dealing with us is the corporate social responsibility angle that we offer. Now, in a large number of cases, is purely a commercial arrangement, but there are some individual companies that really value the contribution from a corporate social responsibility angle that an organisation like ISG can actually give them. So what you end up with is a situation where they may be able to use that in their tendering processes to actually get more credence and more gravitas behind their actual tender themselves. So it does come in handy, but it's something, by and large, what we do with our customers. We are a commercial operation, and that's where our focus is.
Businesses like ISG are expected to generate commercial income to enable them to be financially sustainable. It's often a misconception that supported businesses are either funded by local authorities or rely on the support of local authorities for their commercial work. In the case of ISG, over 85% of sales income in the windows and doors department is generated from the private sector. ISG operates as a purely commercial organisation. Many of our orders are won on the basis of the commercial terms, and not purely because of what we do with disabled people.
You know, in recent years we've had a number of examples where people who have literally come from an environment where they've had nothing in that regard, to achieving even a, what we might regard as a simple job, it's a massive deal for them. And I've had big burly fellas in tears thanking us for the difference we've made to their life. And I find the job in itself really rewarding, managing ISG.
Disabled people have shown over the years that they make willing and committed workers who just want to make their contribution. In its own small way, ISG is making a contribution to the wider aims of society by helping people get back into work.